Howdy y'all, welcome back to Strategy Explained. Today, we're diving into the nostalgic world of movies and exploring the incredible rise and eventual fall of one of the biggest names in the entertainment industry, Blockbuster Video. We'll also talk about four lessons we can learn from their experience. So grab your popcorn, sit back, and let's rewind to the era of VHS tapes and Friday night movie rentals. It all began in the mid-80s when Blockbuster Video emerged as the go-to destination for movie lovers. The concept was simple yet revolutionary. A massive selection of movies available for rent, conveniently located in your neighborhood. Blockbuster's strategic expansion and innovative marketing quickly turned it into a household name. David Cook founded the first Blockbuster in 1985. It was just a standalone mom-and-pop video rental store. But within 2 years, Cook's company grew to 19 locations and attracted the attention of Wayne Huizenga, one of the greatest businessmen in American history. Remember those rows and rows of VHS tapes? If you don't, your parents certainly do. It was like stepping into a treasure trove of cinematic delights. Blockbuster pioneered the concept of the home movie night, and the experience of browsing the aisles, reading movie descriptions, and making that crucial decision on what to watch was something special. In the early days, many customers had to rent the movie player along with the movie. Wayne Huizenga saw potential in the small company and paid $18.5 million for 35% of Blockbuster, a company valuation of about $53 million. Not bad for a two-year-old company. Huizenga had already made a fortune building waste management and was looking for a new challenge. A secret to his success at Waste Management was buying and consolidating many small garbage companies into one efficient national company. So he put his experience to work doing the same thing at Blockbuster. Under Huizenga's leadership, Blockbuster went to work buying hundreds and then thousands of locations to build Blockbuster to a national presence. Within a year, Blockbuster was the largest national video rental chain with 800 stores, and Huizenga grew the company to a multi-billion dollar behemoth. Strategy lesson number one, find a way to make your business operate more efficiently. Blockbuster found a way to achieve economies of scale and efficiency through consolidation. With its blue and yellow signage and that distinct smell of popcorn, Blockbuster became a social hub for families and friends, peaking at 9,000 locations. Friday nights weren't complete without a trip to Blockbuster to pick out the latest releases or classic favorites. But Blockbuster wasn't just about movies. It was the entire experience. The staff recommendations, popcorn at the counter, and even those late fees were all part of the Blockbuster charm. In 1994, just a year after the rise of the internet, Wayne Huizenga sold Blockbuster to Viacom for $8.4 billion. The timing could not have been better. As we all know, nothing lasts forever. External shocks can change any company, and the rise of the internet brought about a significant shift in how we consume entertainment. The rise of DVDs, digital streaming, and mail order movie services posed a serious threat to Blockbuster's traditional business model. Companies like Netflix started offering a new way to watch movies from the comfort of your home. With no late fees and the convenience of streaming, the digital era was quickly becoming the new norm. Strategy lesson number two, adapt to a changing environment. Blockbuster, unfortunately, struggled to adapt to a changing landscape. The convenience and cost-effectiveness of streaming services began to lure customers away. Redbox was cheaper and easier, and Netflix mailed movies directly to your home for a monthly subscription. And then streaming took over everything. The decline was inevitable. In addition to lower cost and greater convenience, the founding of Netflix solved another problem customers had with the big movie rental chains, late fees. In fact, Netflix co-founder Reed Hastings said he started the company because he didn't want to pay $40 in fines that he owed to Blockbuster. I got the idea for Netflix after my company was acquired. I had a big late fee for Apollo 13. It was 6 weeks late and I owed the video store $40. I had misplaced the cassette. It was all my fault. Blockbuster's late fees, once a significant source of revenue, became a point of frustration for customers. Then Blockbuster almost bought Netflix for $50 million, but they decided not to. Given that he made a fortune by not paying his late fees, Maybe Hastings owes Blockbuster those back payments. Strategy lesson number 3. Don't make your customers mad. Sounds simple, but sometimes companies just don't pay attention to what their customers actually think. Blockbuster responded to Netflix by creating Blockbuster Online in 2004, but it was too late. By that time, they were years behind Netflix and could not catch up. In 2010, Blockbuster filed for bankruptcy, and the once mighty empire began closing its iconic blue and yellow stores across the globe. The era of video rental stores was officially coming to an end. But wait, there's a twist in the tale. In the small town of Bend, Oregon, there is one Blockbuster store that defied the odds and still survives. Today, it stands as the last Blockbuster on Earth, serving as a nostalgic reminder of a bygone era. It's not just a store, it's a cultural phenomenon and a testament to the impact Blockbuster had on our lives. Today, it serves not only as a place to rent a video, but also a pseudo museum and tourist attraction for those wishing to connect with former days. It even has thousands of Google reviews and a 4.9 star rating. It may be alone, but the last Blockbuster found a way to survive. Strategy lesson number 4, give customers something special to keep them coming back. And there you have it, the rise and fall of Blockbuster Video, a once thriving giant in the world of entertainment that couldn't quite keep up with rapidly changing times. But hey, the memories of those Friday nights and the excitement of picking out the perfect movie will forever live on. If you enjoyed this trip down memory lane, send it to a friend who also misses Friday nights at Blockbuster and share your favorite Blockbuster memories in the comments below. Until next time, happy watching.